Tonight, she described her husband's death without realizing it was her husband. A Clark County woman starts live tweeting about emergency crews responding to a car crash today, but then slowly discovered this was not just a random accident. The heartbreaking event in Caran Johnson's life grabbed the attention of viewers on K2.com this afternoon. And tonight, K2's Erica Nochlin walks us through the tweets that will be hard to forget.
It begins with a few retweets. The first one from the Washington State Department of Transportation that emergency responders are on their way to I-205 near 83rd Street, that a life flight helicopter is on standby. At this point, Caran Johnson only knows it was a three-car crash and a bad one, so she replies,
I hate that section of I-205 South. Too many on-ramps, speeders, and too few lanes. This accident sounds horrible.
After a few more tweets, she learns there's a fatality and tweets again that it's horrible. She still doesn't know the man who died is her husband. As she continues to listen to scanner traffic, she tweets,
Nice. Two vehicles went around officer blocking on-ramp to I-205 South. Lamos.
And then she slowly starts to wonder.
I'm not trying to panic, but my husband left work early and he drives 205 to get home. He's not answering his phone.
She asks if anyone has a description of the car.
I'm a basket case. I just called his work and he was feeling faint when he left work.
She reveals he has epilepsy and wonders if he had a seizure after several more increasingly panicked tweets.
And now my kids are home from school.
She simply says,
It's him. He died.
Erica Nochlin, K2 News.
Caran Johnson later thanked everybody on Twitter who messaged her with their condolences. In her final tweet tonight, My boys are finally asleep. I feel like a block of cement fell on me. A Washington State patrol is still investigating that crash.